Dear students, is maths a fun? Oh yes, maths is a great fun. In my previous video on integration, I promised that I will give you some shortcut tricks. So here I am. Let us start with the first trick. This trick was already there, but that was in case of indefinite integral. Now this trick is for definite integrals. Let us start it. There is one sere wala dula and other is ghodi par chada hua dula. Now, it is evident from the formula that the limits are from A to B in both the cases. In first case, it is in the square root. In the second case also, it is in the square root. However, in first case, it is in the denominator, whereas it is in the second case, it is in the numerator. Denominator mein hai, niche hai. Aur numerator mein hai, upar hai, ghodi par chada hua hai. Now, the only condition is that x has to be more than a, less than b. In the first case, answer is simply pi. In the second case, answer is pi by 8 into b minus a whole square. So let us start with the example and you will be able to understand properly. Look here. The first example is 3 to 7. First example is 3 to 7. Dx over under root x minus 3, 7 minus x. Now, 3 is less than 7. 3 is less than 7. A is less than B. So here A is 3 and B is 7. So the question satisfies the definition that x has to be between 3 and 7. So the answer in this case will be pi. It is done. Now, let us go to the second magic trick. In this case also, the limits are from 3 to 7 and x lies between 3 and 7. Look here, the first factor says 7 is greater than 3. And in this x is greater than 3. And here it says x is less than 7. So less than 7 is 3. And more than 3 is 7. So it satisfies the condition. X should be between A and B. X here is between A and B. Now the answer is pi by 8. B minus A. What is B here? A is 3, B is 7. So B minus A will become 7 minus 3. As per the formula, it should be 7 minus 3 square. So it is 7 minus 3 square into pi by 8. The answer comes 7 minus 3 is 4. 4 square is 16. 16 by 8, it is 2. Answer is 2 pi. Question is done. So this is such a wonderful trick that if you practice such type of questions more and more at a stretch, then you will remember them and the questions will be very easy to attempt. Now, I am giving you an exercise. There are 6 questions in this exercise. You have to do it yourself. However, I am giving you a hint. Look here in the first question. X is between 2 and 3. Here X is greater than 2. Here 3 is greater than X. In second case, third case, X is greater than 3, less than 4. X is greater than 4, it is greater than 4, less than 5. So, in this question number 1, 3 and 5, the answer will be pi. Question is done. Because it is sere wala dula. Look here, it is in the denominator. It is also in the denominator. It is also in the denominator. In all three, the answer is pi. Now, look here. What will be the answer here? Here, x is greater than 5 and 6 is greater than x. So, it means x lies between 5 and 6. So, answer will be pi by 8, b minus a whole square. So, it will be pi by 8, b is 6, a is 5. So, 6 minus 5 whole square, that is 1. So, answer will be pi by 8. In this case, x is between 6 and 7. X is between 6 and 7. Here, x is greater than 6. And here, x is less than 7. So, the answer will be pi by 8 into b minus a whole square. What is b here? 7. What is a here? 6. What will be 7 minus 6? That is 1. So, pi by 8 into 1 square, that is pi by 8. Answer is pi by 8. Question is done. In this case also, you will get the answer pi by 8 because b minus a is 1. So, simply you have to calculate b minus a here. In the last three questions, 2, 4 and 6, you have to only calculate b minus a. When you find that it is ghodi wala dula, it means you have to find b minus a whole square and multiply by pi by 8. That is all. So, let us go to trick number 2. Look here, it is a trick of the family. Papu is there, mummy is there, daddy is there. Look here, X is Papu, F dash X, mummy, Fx is Papa. Answer will be Papu daddy. Okay, now I have put it in a humorous way and translated it this way. Jab jab Pappu, mummy or daddy saath saath aava. Pappu, mummy and daddy. Pappu, mummy and daddy saath saath aava. Integration trick lagawa. Tab tab answer Pappu daddy aava. Remember it like this. Jab jab Pappu, mummy, daddy saath saath aava. Integration trick lagawa. Tab tab answer Pappu daddy aava. Very simple. So answer is, in this case, Pappu is X and daddy is Fx. So answer will be X into Fx. Very simple. Now let us go to the question part. Look here. Here Pappu is X. Mummy is cos x, that is, it is derivative of sin x. So, what is derivative of sin x? Cos x. So, Pappu, mummy, daddy, saath saath aava, power form, integration formula lagawa. Answer, Pappu, daddy. Pappu, daddy. Now, let us go to the second question. Example, x secant square plus tangent x. Look here, x is Pappu, secant square is derivative of tangent x is daddy, derivative, that is mummy is there, pappu is there. Answer will be pappu daddy. X into tan x. Look here, x into tan x. Let's see. Let us go to the next one. Question is x multiplied e raised to x plus e raised to x. What is derivative of e raised to x? It is e raised to x. Here x is pappu, this is derivative, and this is the function. So answer will be pappu daddy. Pappu is x, daddy is e raised to x. So you find that it is very simple if you remember this mnemonic, and question is done within seconds. Now I have given you an exercise. I'll give you a hint. You can do it yourself. What is derivative of secant x? It is secant x tangent x. X is pappu. Derivative is secant x tangent x. Function is secant x. Answer will be pappu daddy. So it will be x secant x. Now here the question is 1 plus log x. But we do not find 1 over x. Derivative is not there. Neither pappu is there. Pappu, mummy, dono gum hai. Let us create like them. 1 can be written as x multiplied by 1 by x plus log x. Now x is pappu. 1 over x is derivative of log x. So answer will be pappu daddy x log x. Now let us go to the next. X sine x minus cos x. Now what is the derivative of minus cos x? It is sine x. So x is pappu, sine x is derivative, and minus cos x is daddy. So answer will be pappu daddy x into minus cos x. So minus x cos x will be the answer. So you see that questions are very easy if you remember in a fun way. That is, jab jab pappu mummy daddy saath saath aava, integration trick lagawa. Answer aayega pappu daddy. Okay, let us go to the next. Look here, the trick is twin brothers, judwa bhai. Look here, e raised to ax is there, sin bx is there, e raised to ax is there, cos bx there. So sin and cos are considered as function and complement of the function. So they are twins. Now in this case, the answer is e raised to ax over a square plus b square. Within the bracket, a into function minus derivative of the function. So in this case, same thing, a into function minus derivative of the function f dash x. So if you apply this, the questions are very easy. Now look here, the trick is like this. E raised to 2x sine 3x. Now you have to find here a square plus b square. E raised to ax, same. That is e raised to 2x. 2 square plus 3 square is 13. Rest, a sine bx, a is 2. 2 sine 3x minus derivative of sine 3x. That is cos 3x into 3. Question is done. So how you have to do? There's a technique given here. You have to write the value of a. A here is 2. You have to write the value of b, which is 3 here. Find a square plus b square, which becomes 13. So you have to put 13 here. Rest, a into function, that is sine bx, minus derivative of sine bx. Question is done. Now, here in this case, a is 5. Look here, a is 5. B is 2. This is the formula. This is the question. E raised to the power ax into cos bx. A is here, b is here. They are sitting nearby. So you have to identify which is a and which is b. Just write them. A is here 5 and b is 2. So find a square plus b square. That is 5 square plus 2 square. It becomes 29. So answer will be e raised to the power ax, e raised to the power ax over a square plus b square, which is 29. So e raised to the power 5x. So a is 5 into function is cos bx, that is cos 2x. Then find its derivative. Derivative of cos 2x is sine 2x multiplied with 2. Question is done. So same way, I have given you an exercise for doing it at your part, at your home, and there are 6 questions. They are very easy if you follow the above rules. So let us go to the next one. Look here, very simple shortcut technique. 0 to pi by 2. It is relating to definite integral. So, lower limit is 0, upper limit is pi by 2. Question is, dx over a square x square cos square plus b square sine square. Look here, everything is in squares in the denominator. Now, answer is pi over 2ab. You have to find the value of a, you have to find the value of b, put here and the answer is there. Look here. Mostly a square will be given. Supposing in this first question, it is 25. So it is not in the square shape. We can convert this into square, that is 5 square. Similarly, 16 is not in square shape, but it can be written as 4 square. So here a and b will be 5 and 4. The answer will be 2 pi over 2ab, 2 into 5 into 4. Pi over 40. Question is done. Chutki mein. Now let us go to next. Dx over 36 cos square x plus 16 sin square x. Here a square is 36, b square is 16, that is 4 square. So a is 6, b is 4. Answer is pi over 2ab. Pi over 2 into 6 into 4. Now go to the third one. Here a is 7. That is 49 is 7 square. 36 is 6 square. So it is 7 pi over 2 into 7 into 6. Look here. Pi over 2 into 7 into 6. Question is done. So it is pi over 84. Now there is an exercise for you. 6 questions are there. And it is very easy. And let us go to the next technique. Now this, here, this question is also of integration, but we will not be using the integration's symbol. Simply, we can find the answer. Look here, in such type of questions, it is by parts question. integration by parts. You look here, it is written there, integration by parts. So there are two functions, first function and second function. You have to go with I late. In the case of I late, A, T and E are written here. I have cancelled up I and L. Reason being, the questions will be pertaining to only A, T, E. Now, algebra, x raised to power 4. It is coming first in the sequence, so it will be first function. E raised to power x is at the end, it will be second. So, first function has to be, will be depreciated, and second function will be integrated. This method is known as a DI method. D stands for differentiation. I stands for integration. I stands for integration. And when you multiply them, it becomes DI. This DI method was invented by Indians. It is also known as Hindu method. So we will not be using writing the integration symbol. You will be just writing the first function. So first function is x4. Here you have to write the integration of second function. What is integration of e raised to power x? It is e raised to power x. Now go on differentiating here till you reach the end, that is 0. So what is derivative of x4? It is 4x cube. What is derivative of 4x cube? It is 12x square. What is derivative of 12x square? It is 24x. What is derivative of 24x? It is 24. What is derivative of 24? 0. So it comes the end here. Now here you will start with the integral only. So e raised to power x is the integral of e raised to power x. Again e raised to power x. Integral of e raised to power x is e raised to power x. 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 Now we have got d. We have got I. So this is DI method. It means you have to multiply D with I. So look here, x4 into e raised to power x. First of all, you have to put sign here, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus. Alternatively, you have to write, you have to start with plus. So answer will be x4 e raised to power x minus 4x cube e raised to power x plus 12x square e raised to power x minus 24x e raised to power x plus 24 e raised to power x, and 0 into something is 0, no need to write. Similarly, second question is there. It is x square sine 2x. So here I told you that we shall be dealing with questions containing A, T and E. A will be always there. So that is why there are two types of questions. One is A with E, second is A with T. Now we are going with A with T, that is algebra and trigonometry. Here is algebra, here is trigonometry. So firstly, write here x square. This is x square. Write its derivative, 2x. Write the derivative, 2. Derivative of 2x is 2. Write the derivative, 2. It is constant, derivative is 0. So when 0 comes, stop there. You know, you will start with integration of the trigonometrical function. What is integration of sine 2x? It is minus cos 2x by 2. What is integration of minus cos 2x by 2? Integration of minus cos is sine 2x by, and derivative of 2x is by 4. Similarly, integration of minus sine 2x is cos 2x, and derivative of 2x is 2, 4 into 2 is 8. Similarly, no need to write here, because 0 into something, it will become 0. Write the plus, minus, plus, minus. These signs have to be put alternatively, starting with plus, plus, minus, plus, minus. Now, we have got D. we have got I, multiplied D with I, and you get the answer. So, I have given you the exercise. Do it yourself. Now, there's one more technique. This technique is 1 over Q. Q stands for quadratic function. That is AX square plus BX plus C. Q stands for quadratic polynomial. Now, technique is, its answer is 2 over root D, tangent inverse, derivative of Q divided root of D. Look here, both places you have to write root D. Now, I have given, D must be negative. Condition is, the must condition is discriminant D should be negative. If D is not negative, you won't be able to apply this technique. So, in this case, I have calculated D in each case. Look here, first example is integration of dx over 5x square plus 6x plus 5. Here A is 5, B is 6, C is 5. Value of D comes minus 64. So, D has to be negative. Look here, it is negative. This is fine. Now, derivative of Q, and Q here is 5x square plus, quadratic is 5x square plus 6x plus 5. Derivative of 5x square, 10x. Derivative of 6x is 6. So it is 10x plus 6. Now put in the formula and you get the answer. The formula is already written there. Now look here, formula is here. 2 over root D, 2 over root 64. You have to write plus here because it will otherwise become imaginary, because in the square root minus sign cannot be written. So you have to write here D has to be negative. Negative, negative, it becomes positive. So you have to write positive here. So it is 2 over 64, tangent inverse, derivative divided by root D. In all these cases, you have to do like this. You make a chart like this at your place and do the questions. Questions are here. 4 questions are there. You do it at your place. I hope that these techniques, if you use them properly, you will be able to get good marks in your IIT JEE exams. And in the case of plus 2 exams, you will be able to verify your answer quickly, and you will be sure whether you have attempted the questions properly or not. So this is the first part of the series of short tricks. I shall be gone with more tricks, shortcut tricks, so that you are benefited. I hope these tricks will be of use to you, and it will be good if you remember them properly and practice more. I wish you all the best. Thank you. Go on subscribing my channel, and I'll be there with you with more and more short tricks on integration. Thank you so much.